Good morning. How is everybody doing today? Today is the October 30th, 2019. We are in Stockton, California. It is a brisk 45 degrees. Here it's almost 4:30 in the morning. We got loaded yesterday. I didn't get to sleep until much later than I wanted to, but we did get loaded. Got some much needed rest. Had a long night. Now we're gonna get rolling. Like I said, we're in Stockton, California. We're gonna be going to Portland, Oregon. We're going all the way up Route 5. I think we're gonna start out this morning doing some time warp at night again, so I can kind of hurry up through the nighttime video. Then once we hit Northern California after Sacramento and all that, I'm probably gonna put it on a regular looping video, maybe like some 10K, or maybe even mess with some linear or 4K. We're gonna be going through some nice country, some nice woods, gonna see some nice mountains, and that'll be during the daytime, and I'll slow the footage down so we can get some good video, and I can talk through it. Maybe play some music. Although it is YouTube, it's hard to do the music except for what they have when I edit the videos and add music to it, whatever they have, the boring stuff. Gotta figure out how people do that. Other than that, it's gonna be a good day. We're gonna be in Portland at our stop by dinner time tonight. So hopefully we'll be able to sleep there, do our delivery at 4:30 in the morning. Won't have to run tomorrow. I think we're going to be off tomorrow. I think I'm going to have to do a restart and get my 34-hour restart in to get my hours back. And then, I was hoping this load would in towards Florida so I can go home for a day. I've been out for quite a while. Been out for over five weeks now, almost 5.5 weeks. Missed the family. Really not gonna have any home time until Thanksgiving, but I was hoping to go home for at least a day. Pick someone up so I can have some company in the truck until Thanksgiving. But it doesn't look like I'm gonna be getting home anytime soon since I'm going to Portland. And that's on the totally opposite corner of the country and couldn't be any further from Florida than Portland, Oregon, I guess, unless I ran up to Washington. But we'll see. Hopefully I can get home for at least a day just to say hi to everybody, say hi to the fam. But I guess I'm going to be quiet now, and at the end of the street up here, I'll switch it to time warp so we can go fast through the nighttime driving and hopefully catch up with some daytime. Have a good day, everyone. Enjoy.
Turn right on. 500 feet. Turn right on Arch Road.
off I-5, we're going to be pulling into the Loves up here, getting some fuel. I'm just going to get just enough to get out of California. Fuel's very expensive. All gas is expensive in California. It's ridiculous. I think regular gas is, what is it? I don't even know. I can't even see what the sign says. $4.04 a gallon. Diesel's almost $4 a gallon. I'm not gonna get too much here. I'll wait until I get to work out where it's almost a buck cheaper. Sun's coming up. It's still 47 degrees, so it's still a little chilly out here. We went by the area where the wildfires were.
Keep left.
It wasn't too bad. It was not really near I-5. It was more west towards the coastline, I guess. So we kind of missed all of that. But hopefully now that the sun is coming up, I'm going to be able to shoot some daytime footage. I'm going to do regular footage and a little bit of time warp during the day because, you know, I still have another 8 hours of driving, 8.5 hours of driving. And I don't think you guys want to see 8 hours of just driving. So, you know, I'll time warp it just like I did on the nighttime footage. Like I said, I'm gonna stop over here at the Loves. I'm gonna take me a little restroom break, get some fuel, and I'm gonna keep on moving until I can get up to Portland, Oregon.
Turn left, then turn left.
Been a good day so far, not a lot of traffic. We made it through Sacramento really well. It was probably around 5:30-ish when I went through. And usually that early in California is still traffic. Especially in LA or Orlando in Florida, you know, we traffic 24 hours a day. I guess we gotta wait.
Turn left, then turn left. 0.1 miles ahead.
So let me get some fuel, guys, and I'll come back to you and talk to you a little bit when we start moving. I'll talk to you guys in a little bit. Okay, guys, back on the interstate now. I got some fuel. But more importantly, I got coffee. When I'm on the road, I cannot go without coffee. I don't know. It doesn't keep me up or anything. It doesn't have that effect on me. I don't know. Maybe I need to put a couple shots of espresso or something in them or whatever. But I'm on the keto diet anyway. Coffee kind of kills my appetite for a little while. All I really have in the morning is my Muscle Milk or my protein drink. Other than that, I take a few of these keto tablets. I can do a little short video and a little review on them, actually, because they're actually really good. I know certain things work for certain people and certain things don't work for others. But they work for me. I've been on them for a couple weeks now, probably, I want to say 5 weeks. And I really like how I feel on the tablets that I take. I definitely have my coffee every morning. Sometimes it's different times of the day, depending on when I drive, when I start, when I stop. But since I'm on a keto diet also, I don't put any kind of cream or whatever. I really don't need, I definitely don't put sugar. I usually put equal or two, but lately I haven't even had to do that. It's just a black coffee. I have a little bit of heavy cream. And again, I can do it on a lot of things. But I'm not giving up my French vanilla. And I get a sugar-free French vanilla from Walmart. But it's got 2 grams of carbs in it for 2 tablespoons. So I just put a little bit in it. It's probably maybe 1 tablespoon. It's probably half of what that is. So I get about a carb. My sugar to me is about 1 carb for the day. Now, after that, and then whatever the 3 carbs I get from my Muscle Milk or protein, I can start that day off every day with only 4 carbs because I got to keep it under 20 a day. Remember, I got 20 net carbs a day. That's good for me. I'll be good. I'll have a Quest bar later for lunch. And then, I don't know. My meals differ every day. I try and change it up sometimes. It's all healthy stuff and I still don't have the carbs. But however, I mean, very important that I have my coffee or I would not be talking to you guys right now. That and a restroom break. Where I was at last night, I wasn't able to use the restroom. They don't have one for drivers. So I was parked on the street. So I had to make sure that I used the bathroom before. before I left there and didn't have anything to drink or eat. This way, I don't have to worry about that until this morning. But I'm going to put this on time warp again for a little while. Oh, and guys, I want to mention too, and I say guys, but it's guys and girls who's ever watching it. No offense to any. I just, normal for me, just say guys. The videos are going to be a little bit behind because, you know, when you're out here, you know, there's times I don't even stop at a truck stop, not unless a place with Wi-Fi. So I gotta depend on cell service to upload videos, you know, and sometimes when I get my break, I got a few things I gotta do, you know, laundry, other things, you know what I mean, and I don't have time to do it all the time. I will try and do it daily, but now, like last night, yesterday's driving video, it's been almost 5 hours now that it's been uploading to YouTube for it to post. Once it posts, it is on my Facebook site. You can check out Trucking with Seabiscuit on Facebook. They upload a lot faster than YouTube. It is on that site right now. It's on Facebook. Trucking with Seabiscuit on Facebook. Give that a like. Review it. Whatever you want to do, but show some kindness. You know, I like it. I like the positivity. If it's a negative feedback, that's okay too. I like to know what I'm doing wrong. But if you can, just let me know. But they take a little while, so they may be a day or so behind. But they're going to get up. I'm going to do daily videos of my life in trucking, what we go through, and I'm going to show you some good scenery. Not much going on right now. I mean, other than I'm still in California and the speed limit is 55, people are still doing 45. I guess it's early. They don't want to go that fast. You know, I-5 is kind of boring California until I get to Northern California near Weed, California. And, you know, I get into some of the mountains. It's pretty beautiful. A lot of, I don't even know what these are. I think these are olive trees or something. I don't know. I think we're in wine country up here. But, yeah, California is pretty long to go through. I am at mile marker. I don't even know. Probably around C-ish, somewhere around there. And there's almost 800 miles. Florida. So I still got another 150 miles to do in Florida. Still got another 469 miles to do for today. So keep pretty busy. I got just enough time on my clock. For those of you who don't know, you know, we're only allowed to drive and work so many hours a day. The only job in the world where they dictate how much we can make. I'm sure there's others, but we get a bad rap right now in the trucking industry. So I do the best I can. And I got just enough time to get where I'm going so I can do my delivery first thing in the morning and then, you know, get to a truck stop or somewhere where I can do my 34-hour restart, do some walking, get some exercise in. I try and walk as much as I can when I can. Very hard. I do a lot of sitting since I'm a truck driver. But I am with the keto diet. I am getting back down. Last weigh-in, I was at 186. Well, that the last weigh-in. Weigh-in before that was at 187. I'm actually at 190 now. I gained 3 pounds back. Don't know how, but we're gonna get back down to that. My first, I've reached a lot of goals. My next goal is to, I wanna get under 180. I wanna get the 180 mark again. Eventually, I wanna see 174 where I was before I moved down to New Jersey. I was doing very well. I was in great shape. Probably the best shape of my life that I was ever in before I left New Jersey. But yeah, not much of a difference now. You know, a few pounds back, but I was up there again. But I'm on my path to losing it. I'm on my path to getting healthier out here. You know, I gotta live longer. I gotta see the family, you know? I don't wanna give up. I wanna keep it going for them. Nothing more in this world that I love more than my family. Family means the most, and it should mean the most to every one of you out there. That's why it kind of kills me to do this, to be out here. But I'm only supposed to be out 4 to 5 weeks at a time. You know, I like to be home every 3 to 4 right now, but trying to catch up on some bills. And this company goes pretty far distances, and sometimes it's a little hard to get home on scheduled time, which is okay as long as they can get me home when I have things to do on holidays. Well, with all that said, because I can talk for a long time, especially when the camera's not pointed at me. yeah, when I'm driving like this, I can't do anything anyway. And even if I did a live feed, you know, I can't. I can't. can't control what people say or what they're saying to me. I wouldn't be able to look at the screen. You know, today's world, you can't use your phones and everything while you're driving. Thankfully, the GoPro Hero 8, non-advertisement, I'm not sponsored by GoPro, but the camera that I have now is voice-controlled. I can drive down the road and I can just yell. I don't want to do it right now because it'll turn off or it'll turn on, but you can do commands and it will start, stop recording. I do not know if you can change, settings and things like that as far as going to, you know, like time warp and stuff. I probably have to pull over to do things like that. But as far as just getting it to record where I can talk to you guys like this, it does allow me to do that. Need drives on the road, especially in a truck. You know, you're 80,000 pounds. It's no joke out here. There's a lot of accidents, a lot of four-wheelers cutting us off and doing stupid things around us because stupid people do stupid things. I say that often, and I will say that so many times. Should almost be my little slogan for my my Facebook site, my YouTube site, because it's true. Not that people are stupid, because I don't believe anybody is truly stupid. People are people. Everyone's different. But at point in times, different times of the day, people do stupid things. Yes, I do too. Just because I do something stupid doesn't mean I'm stupid, or doesn't mean you're stupid. But stupid people do stupid things. And at certain times, everybody becomes stupid for a minute there. Everybody has little brain farts. You know what I mean? I'm going to keep trucking here. I don't know how I can't zoom in or anything. I don't know how much you can see. It looks like a little bit of snow on top of that mountain ahead of us there. I wish I could turn the camera. I almost wish I could have like two cameras, one on each side of the truck to face sideways, because it looks like the mountains are always towards the end, you know, on the side of the truck and not straight forward. You know, but California is beautiful to drive through. I don't live here, you know. Certain times I think I do because it's really quiet in certain areas, not like LA where it's really busy. But you know, I like living in mountains that I never have. I've always lived on the eastern coast. I've never even lived in like the Midwest or any place like that. But for truckers, California can be kind of dangerous because we're only supposed to do 55, and I kind of do around 60-ish, 58 to 62. Out of respect for law enforcement, if I do see I do slow down. Hopefully, you know, they'll see that and they'll be like, well, you saw us, he slowed down. I don't get speeding tickets. I try not to speed. I don't like to speed. No one out there else should either. But when the speed limit is 55 for trucks and the cars can still do 70 miles an hour, and you know, if the speed limit is 70 for cars, they're going to do 75, 80. But even if they're doing 70 and they're coming up to a truck doing 55, that's like a brake check for them. And earlier when I was passing a truck that was only doing 40 miles an hour, I got in front of that truck. Now when I switch back over, I make sure there's plenty of room between me and that truck. I don't like coming right over. Most states, that's law, leave room for trucks or anybody really, but for trucks, you're supposed to leave them room. And I don't like cutting right over, so I give them that space. And when I give them that space, you know, there's cars that are doing 70 plus behind me, and they're cutting over between me and the other truck, and they're going next to me, and that closes my gap where I can't get over. And everyone's following in his footsteps, and they're all doing that, and now I'm stuck in the center lane doing 55, and they're cutting by and doing that, and then they wonder why there's accidents. I think the speed limit should be the speed limit. That's it. If it's 70, then it should be 70 for trucks and 70 for cars. You know, if there's weather or conditions or traffic, well, then you know what? Then people should adjust to that. I mean, whether you're in a truck or a car, you know what I mean? It doesn't matter. Speed limit should be the speed limit no matter where you are. You know, it's dangerous to have two different speed limits. There's a couple states that have three speed limits. There's some states, I think, I want to say it's Illinois. Maybe it's Wisconsin. Maybe it was Wisconsin, or maybe it's Michigan. I don't know. I want to say it's either Michigan or Wisconsin. I'm leaning on Wisconsin, guys. And girls, sorry. I always say guys. That just means anybody watching. Sorry. There's three speed limits. They have one for buses, too. Really weird. why they do that, you know. But hey, whether it's a speed limit or whatever, law is a law. You're supposed to do it. You've got to be a professional out here as a truck driver. You always have to assume that people are going to do stupid things in front of you. And they do. Let me tell you, driving for a while, I've had people drive with me. Probably the most is probably my son, Michael. But he can tell you, I don't make this stuff up, guys. The stuff that happens out here and what four-wheelers do in front of us, it's amazing. It really is. It's amazing. It's crazy the things you see out here and the things people do, you know. Truck drivers anywhere, everybody does things like that. And again, stupid people, meaning everybody at that time, having a stupid moment. Okay, guys, we're back. Sorry about that. I had to pull over and mess with the camera. Apparently, it got too hot and shut off. I don't know. I use it as my dash cam, too. This way, if something happens, I can prove that I wasn't at fault, or I can see what happened. Or, you know, if somebody hits my truck and I'm not at it, I know what happened and no one to blame. But it's back on and rolling. We are still in Northern California. We're a little bit further down the road than we were. I have to let the camera cool down. Like I said, I got a lot of things I got to work on with the camera until I can do my review. I will be doing a one-week review coming up soon on it, and my thoughts so far. I don't know. If somebody, I don't know if any of y'all out there have a GoPro. If you can let me know, the biggest thing I'm having an issue with right now is I can't push the button on it to stop recording. Hey guys, sorry about all the confusion earlier. Gotta do some editing. Apparently had some technical issues with the GoPro. I'm working through it. Like I said, it's the first one I've had, so it kept overheating. I took my half hour break. The sun was beating on it through the windshield, I guess. So I gotta work it out, where to put it. We're working on it. But I'm at my delivery. It's at 4:30 in the morning. We're in Portland, Oregon. This video I'm gonna do edit tonight. I'll post it. It'll be up by morning time. Then I'm off tomorrow and probably half the day Friday. So my next video probably won't be uploaded until maybe over the weekend. But I'll probably do one. You know, unless I go walking somewhere or something, maybe do a little quick video and just chit-chat. But, you know, I'll probably do one for over the weekend, you know, small one, and post that Monday morning. So, I'm going to go eat a salad for a little while, and I guess I will talk to you all in the morning. Have a good night. And as usual, to my family at home, I'll be home soon. Not yet, kind of load the Chicago area for Tuesday delivery, and then hopefully from there going home. But you know, to my wife and kids, my mom at home, love you guys, miss you guys, and I'll be there soon. Everybody else, have a good weekend, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Stay safe, everyone. Bye.